Merry Christmas. Today, I will be helping with a Christmas cookie show. We will be making traditional shortbread Christmas cookies from Germany, hidden mint surprise cookies, and chocolate peppermint pinwheel cookies. Now, the word cookie comes from a Dutch word meaning little cake, koekje, and the Pennsylvania Dutch, those dessert masters of the world, evolved them into Christmas cookies by cutting them out into Christmas shapes once they got to the New World and Christmas became a little more commercial in the 1800s. And now, to the kitchen!
Alright, we are going to count down to the beginning of cookie making, Christmas cookie making 2008. 3, 2, 1, begin!
Okay.
Will is sifting the flour.
Baking powder.
John Ward is unwrapping butter. And it is snowing again.
Okay, I am making chocolate peppermint pinwheel cookies. To start, we are going to need like a basic sugar cookie dough. From a sugar cookie dough, we are going to need 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 3 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon of kosher salt, 1 cup of unsalted butter softened, 1 cup of sugar, 1 egg beaten, and 1 tablespoon of milk. Then, and we'll get back to how to make the dough.
Okay, my recipe is shortbread cookies, but are wonderful for cutout Christmas cookies. This only needs 4 ingredients, but here's a lot of stuff. 4 sticks of butter or margarine, 1 cup sugar, 1 teaspoon of milk, and 4 cups flour.
Once you have made your sugar cookie dough, we can move on to the chocolate peppermint part. You're gonna need 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon of peppermint extract, 3 ounces of unsweetened chocolate melted. You can use a double broiler or the microwave, up to you. Also, 1 egg yolk to be peppermint batter for fat and moisture. And 1/2 cup of crushed candy canes or peppermint candies. Once you have made your dough, you are going to want to split it into two even portions. To one, you add 1 teaspoon of peppermint extract and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract.
Oh no, not a green food color.
Okay. Now. Now for the chocolate part, which is the one you added the vanilla extract to, or hopefully you remember which one you added vanilla extract to. You're gonna wanna melt 3 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate in a microwave. You can use chocolate chips or those bars they sell down at the grocery store. It doesn't make much of a difference. And also, you're gonna need 1/2 cup of peppermint candies or candy canes crushed. And add that to the peppermint extract dough. The only other difference is add an egg yolk to the peppermint extract dough. Thank you.
Okay, this is our annual Christmas cookie dough rolling out lesson. First, we flour the counter, and we got a nice thing of moist cookie dough, and we floured the roll. And then, let's see how John learned from last year. Too gently without pressing too hard. Push in and out, skating across the top, not applying a lot of pressure. Then we stop, and we turn it this way. And get the edges. John has remembered from 2007. Here's John cutting out the Christmas cookies as close as they can get to each other. Well done. These are waiting to go into the oven. William has spent the last 20 minutes unwrapping peppermints to grind up, and now he is mixing the dough.
By hand. You can do this with a spoon, but this is much more fun.
The chocolate.
Okay, yes. The chocolate, vanilla extract, and sugar cookie dough batch. And here's the sugar cookie dough, peppermint extract, and crushed peppermint candies. Once that's mixed, add an egg yolk to the peppermint one for fat and moisture. Okay, for our hidden mint cookies, we have taken a roll of sugar cookie dough, about 18 ounces, and cut them out into about quarter inch thick pieces. Now lay them out about 2 to 3 inches apart on a pan, and top each of them with a chocolate wafer. Well, one of these little chocolate mint wafers. Then top with another piece of sugar cookie dough. Now, respective doughs have chilled for 5 minutes in the refrigerator. Now we have to roll them out to about a quarter of an inch thickness. Now make sure you make the chocolate just a little bit bigger than a peppermint. Okay, now a peppermint dough is going to be a little harder to work with because there's actually solid material in here. So you might want to take the edge of the rolling pin and just kind of do that. Trust me, it'll come out exactly the same. Now make sure you roll the chocolate out just a little bit bigger than a peppermint or else this recipe is going to flop on you. Once you have rolled it into a log, you have rolled the two together into a nice log, stash it in your refrigerator for 2 hours. Wait, okay. We are now gonna cut the cookies after 2 hours in the refrigerator into half inch slices, then straight into a 375 degree oven for 12 to 13 minutes. One thing I should mention about this log, that you can wrap it up and freeze it for up to 6 months if you want to. Actually, they make great, you can make this in August and just whip it out at Christmas and you'll be ready.
It's now 8:47 at night, 5 hours and 47 minutes after we started making cookies. We have some success. The beautiful chocolate peppermint swirls. Lovely Christmas cookies. And we have one failure. The mint surprise blob.
Could that be growling? My legs feel like straws. Oh me, my. Kindly, would you reply? Is that you, Santa Claus? Oh, yeah!